Now we're going to take a look at some examples of these continuation patterns, and I want to show you just how frequently they come and how often they show up within these trends. Here we're looking at Apple, and this is a beautiful uptrend in Apple throughout 2014, and just a nice clean flag, just a nice healthy digestion of those gains that came in a beautiful uptrend with higher lows, higher highs, above an upward sloping 200-day moving average. And then notice how as soon as we broke out above the upper end of this range, the rally in Apple was able to continue the previous trend, which is obviously higher. Now here we're looking at a symmetrical triangle, and I think it's a great example of the fact that the market isn't as clean as some of these examples that I drew out for you. The reality of the matter is they're a little bit messy. That's just the way Mr. Market likes to roll. In this case, we have a symmetrical triangle where there are two trend lines definitely converging and prices are definitely consolidating within an uptrend, but they're not perfectly converging, right? So further evidence that the names of what these patterns are, again, are less important than the implications. Very simply, once we breach the upper end of that range, the trend is ready to resume. We're seeing the same thing in US Treasury bonds in early 2016. Nice uptrend, a nice descending triangle defined on the upper end by a declining downtrend line. And then the bottom end of the range is defined by a horizontal trend line. As usual, once the upper end of the range is breached, it is evidence to us that this consolidation is now over, that digestion of gains has been completed, and now we can resume the underlying trend, which in this case was an uptrend. We're looking at a bar chart of US Treasury bonds, the ETF TLT, and notice how we are in an uptrend above an upward sloping 200-day moving average, and then momentum has been in a bullish range this entire time, staying away from oversold conditions, consistently getting overbought, essentially giving us further evidence that yes, indeed, this consolidation should resolve in the direction of the underlying trend, and then of course it did. Here is the Dow Jones Broker Dealers Index. Okay, this is in the fall of 2016. You have a monster rally off of the summer lows, a nice healthy sideways consolidation. Maybe you can call this a rectangle. Maybe you can call it a symmetrical triangle. It really doesn't matter. It's clearly a consolidation, a digestion of the prior gains. Once we breach the upper end of that range, it signals to us that the underlying trend is ready to resume. And of course, broker dealers rallied into the end of the year, as they should have. Here we're looking at shares of Visa. This is more of a little bit of a pennant, maybe a little bit of a flag, but just quick and dirty, not necessarily something that takes a prolonged period of time, but something more short term. This is evidence of some of the stronger markets. And here in Visa, in the fall, we have a nice little consolidation. It breaks the upper end of that range, and the uptrend in Visa can then resume. Notice how our polarity principles that we discussed before are also coming into play. That resistance is now turning into support on the kickback. So all of these tools that we've discussed throughout the educational series, we want to continue to apply those as we learn new tools. Here we're looking at a couple of different consolidation patterns. This is healthcare throughout 2013, the exchange-traded fund XLV. Here you have a nice little falling wedge within an uptrend. Notice how momentum has not hit oversold conditions throughout this entire chart, evidence of an uptrend. Prices are making higher lows, higher highs above an upward sloping 200-day moving average. I get further evidence of an uptrend. So yes, this falling wedge should have resolved higher, and it did. This nice little symmetrical triangle, little pennant sort of formation, again, should have resolved higher, and it did, because there is a much higher likelihood that a consolidation is going to resolve in the direction of the underlying trend than just simply reversing on the spot and turning around. Here we're looking at the currency market. When we apply our technical analysis tools, it's not just for the stock market. It's not just for ETFs. We're looking at commodities. We're looking at the Forex market. We're looking at ratios. That's the beauty of technical analysis, being able to apply our tools across the board. Here we're looking at a downtrend in the US dollar relative to the Japanese yen, USD JPY. Very clear downtrend, lower lows, lower highs. Nice little descending triangle, symmetrical-ish, maybe even a rectangle. But the bottom line is, as soon as the lower end of that range is breached, it is evidence to us that the downtrend is now ready to resume lower. And finally, we're going to finish up with crude oil futures. And this is at the end of 2014. Crude oil is absolutely getting destroyed. One of the strongest downtrends on earth at the time. And then sure, beautiful downtrend, nice little symmetrical triangle, rising wedge sort of pattern. But once you resolve to the downside, breach that lower end of the range, that's the evidence that we need that suggests that the underlying trend is now ready to continue. Getting back to our polarity principles, once we broke down and broke below support, that kickback was very fadeable. That's the kickback that we want to be fading, not buying. So we broke down, kicked back, retested former support, and then resumed with our downtrend, the trend that was in place prior.